Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children, and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord. Leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed, for you have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord Jesus said, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs or elsewhere is a thief and a robber. Words from the Gospel today from St. John. Plain words, those who love me are willing to follow me. For anyone who does not love the truth has not yet fully come to know it. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, you have heard the test we pastors have to undergo. Turn now to consider how these words of our Lord apply a test for you also. Ask yourselves whether you belong to his flock, whether you know him, whether the light of truth, his truth shines in your mind and hearts. I assure you that it is not by faith that you will fully come to know him, by love. Not by mere conviction, but by action. John the Evangelist is my authority for this statement. He tells us that anyone who claims to know God without keeping his commandments is a liar. Consequently, the Lord immediately adds, as the Father knows me and I know the Father, I'm going to lay down my life for my sheep. Clearly, he means that laying down his life for his sheep gives evidence of his knowledge of the Father and the Father's knowledge of him. In other words, by the love with which he dies for his sheep, our Lord shows how greatly he loves his Father and all of us. Again, he says, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me, and I give them eternal life." Shortly before this, the Lord Jesus declared, "If anyone enters the sheepfold through me, he shall be saved. He shall go freely in and out to find good pasture." He will enter into a life of faith. From faith, he will go out to vision. From belief to contemplation, and will graze in the good pastures of everlasting life. So the Lord's sheep will finally reach their grazing ground, where all who follow him in simplicity of heart will feed on the green pastures of eternity. These pastures are the spiritual joys of heaven. There they look upon the face of God with unclouded vision and feast at the banquet of eternal life forevermore. Beloved, let us set out for these pastures where we shall keep joyful festival with so many of our fellow citizens. May the thought of their happiness urge us on. Let us stir up our hearts. Let us rekindle our faith and long eagerly for what heaven has in store for us. For to love like this is to already be on our way. No matter what obstacles we encounter, this virus or whatever, we must not allow it or them to turn us aside from the joy of that heavenly feast. Anyone who is determined to reach his destination is not deterred by the roughness of the road that leads to it, nor must we allow the charm of success to seduce us. Or as it's been said, we should be like a foolish traveler who is so distracted by the pleasant meadows to which he is going that he forgets where he's going. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For thou art with me. With thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and thy mercy will follow me forevermore, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, down to heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate by the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now offer our prayers, our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For Pope Francis, as chief shepherd of the flock, that he may inspire us and motivate us to be authentic Catholic Christians who live and practice their faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parish family of St. Barnabas, that through the real presence of Christ and the Holy Eucharist, we may all grow more in love with God and seek to love in response to this sacrament of love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the children who will be making their first Holy Communion, that they may be given strong faith and reverence for Jesus in the most sacred body and blood, and never take him for granted by attending the Holy Mass every weekend or whenever possible. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all to be confirmed, that they may witness to their Catholic faith, especially by their practice and adherence to its teachings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that more young men and women may seek God's will over their own, and thereby be more willing to offer their lives in sacrifice for the love of God and neighbor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in reverence and respect for all human life, that life, no matter its limitations, may be understood and valued as sacred and irreplaceable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a soon end to the pandemic, for all who have died, and for the protection of all healthcare professionals, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world peace and end to terrorism, and for safety to those who protect us in the military and law enforcement, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal needs and intentions that reside in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the intention this Mass is having for Jerry and Rose Corti. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and grant our prayers, all our petitions. We ask them all in faith and trust that Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit of God, forever and ever. Amen. compassion for souls, health and well-being, and paying homage to you, eternal God, the eternal. Thank you for those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse. We bless the apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers that all things be defended by your protecting God. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service that we have people offer to your glories and majesty through the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Please look upon these offerings with a serene kind countenance, and to accept them as much as we're pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father of faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, the holy sacrifice, the spotless victim. Prayer we ask, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angels, your altar on high, and the sanctity of your majesty, so that all of us who through this participation be able to receive the most holy body of your Son, and be filled with every grace and every blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace.
Oh.
My Jesus, I embrace thee as one who has already come. I unite myself to thee, never permitting to be separated from thee. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle on eternal pastures the sheep you have reached.